There are several types of caches when it comes to which blocks can be placed where in the cache. The cache examples we have seen so far are the fully associative caches. In this type of a cache, any block from memory can be placed into any line in the cache. So if the cache has room for 16 lines, then we need to search up to 16 tags in order to find whether the block we are looking for is actually in the cache. The opposite of that is a direct map cache, where for a given block there is exactly one place in the cache where that block can go. That means that we only need to check one line in the cache if it contains that block, because that's the only line where it can possibly be. Different blocks, of course, will still be able to map to different lines, but a particular block can only go into one place in the cache. And then, of course, there is the middle ground between them, which is called a set associative cache, where there are n lines where a block can be. Now, n typically will be larger than 1 and smaller than the total number of lines in the cache. So we can really view the direct map cache as a case of a set associative cache where n is 1, and the fully associative cache is an extreme case of a set associative cache where n is equal to the number of lines in the cache. But what we normally call a set associative cache has a relatively small n compared to the number of blocks in that cache, yet that n typically is 2, 4, or 8, so it's larger than 1. Now let's look at each of these types of caches.